Yeah, like
this is going to have the internet go nuts right now. All the gamers is just punching. You bought a 2080 Ti. You punching air right now. You punching air like. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Leon here, and today we have a very special event. It's the NVIDIA GeForce special event, and I'm with here with my buddy, my co-host, Mr. Yumi.
What's good, y'all? Sasuke Yomi in the building.
Him and I, we have this cool podcast called Homeroom. So you can take a look at this. Take a look at it. I'll have the link to our Homeroom discussion.
Below.
Yes. So yeah. So you know, he's a big gamer, and you know, and I'm a 3D artist, so it's kind of a good collab. So we're gonna take a look and see what NVIDIA got for us, especially since he got his new PC. Yes, sir.
We finally in the PC territory, man. Finally. It's a good feeling.
Yeah, it's a very good feeling.
Mm-hmm. First step to the new beginnings, man. New journey ahead.
Yeah, so let's get into it.
Let's get it. GeForce special event, y'all.
Wow, this is some old school game, man.
Right. Look at this. Whoosh, Warcraft. I never played Warcraft, it's crazy. Wait, shit. Black Ops, man.
Yeah, Black Ops.
That was that game. Rocket League is a big deal, man. It's a pretty big deal.
Yeah, I'm really digging this.
I've never been a big fan of Battlefield.
Yeah, me either.
Battlefield, wow. Warfare.
Welcome to my kitchen.
Okay.
I hope all of you are staying safe.
Welcome to my kitchen.
We're going to talk about an amazing GPU today.
Look at their system is creating.
I'll
watch.
Show you NVIDIA Broadcast.
Hey everybody, I'm Brandon and I'm very excited today to talk to you about our NVIDIA Broadcast app. Like many of you, I've been home a lot more lately. I've been video conferencing all day and then gaming and streaming all night. And I have a very basic webcam and microphone setup. NVIDIA Broadcast makes these things supercharged with a lot of new awesome features that really bring it out using the power of AI and RTX GPUs.
So yeah.
The first one I want to talk about is noise removal. So I've asked my girlfriend to join me with a blow dryer here.
They have like noise removal.
That sound makes it very hard to understand what I'm saying. But when I turn on noise removal in NVIDIA Broadcast.
That's clutch, to be honest.
Yeah, so NVIDIA itself.
So many different things.
Yeah, so NVIDIA usually you had to wait for like third party apps to create these features. So now NVIDIA, what they did is that they created So once you buy the graphics card, you can use the NVIDIA app. And the NVIDIA app, there's an option to have noise suppression. So when you're streaming, like for example, what he just showed is like he's streaming, he's talking to his audience, then his girlfriend comes in the room with the air dryer.
Right.
The AI system is going to mute the noise suppression.
Technology.
Yeah,
it
is technology, man.
That comes first up, you have clutch right there, man. Especially for me, I can use that. I come in handy.
A very cluttered when I saw room.
Yeah, and he's in the same webcam I got. I'm using it right now.
Yeah, that's dope.
All of a sudden, no, they have the background blur feature.
And I can adjust the strength of that from low to high and everything in between.
I mean, these features are not new. Like Microsoft Office has it, but
I guess it's more convenient now.
It's convenient now because you don't have to use Microsoft Office.
Easy accessible, man. Can't go wrong with that.
I want to jump into some gameplay. I can remove the background altogether. And jump into some Valorant.
Wow. Yo, you know what's crazy?
I'm playing with a green screen
effect. Like investing in this is like you don't have to get green screen.
Play good, but at
yeah,
least that, I can look
that's
good.
Why they're creating this AI system. So sometimes, like I wanted to have an AI system in
chatting stream.
I wanted to have like a AI a green screen in the back, but I was like, yeah, it's too much work. Like look at my setup here, you know, like to get a green screen and put it here would be too cumbersome. Right, with this app now. It's gonna use this AI magic and just like clear it up.
I'm in the same boat too.
Yeah, what would be cool is that if you can figure out how what to do with a mic that you have in your face all the time.
Right.
I guess you got to put it in front of you somehow, but we'll see.
Or to the side with like a handle.
To get a more personal connection with the audience. But the problem is I bounce around so much, it's easy for my head to get out of frame. With the auto frame feature,
that's so awesome, man.
It's like having your own personal cameraman that follows you wherever you go.
Look, they have the auto frame feature.
So, for example, I wanted to reach over and grab my cool Valorant hat.
Wow.
Yeah, it follows
show
you.
Show it to everybody. It follows me every step of
This is like...
The AI follows you when you move your head. That's just like crazy.
It reminds me of Kinect for 360. Well, and Xbox One, yeah.
Improve your background and keep yourself in the center of the frame.
That's dope, man.
It's dope. It's really dope.
This is great... Ladies and gentlemen, to me... Already, this sounds like a great investment, man. Like, this is definitely a great investment. Artists
are using like NVIDIA, they're making very good strides, you know? Because, as I said, some of these features were out there before, but to have it built in with your graphics card and it's being, like, you know, GPU accelerated, that's great. I don't need to, you know, like, fire up extra software to have this done. You know, exactly. Think about it. You just buy a webcam, boom, it works, you know?
Major key alert. Major key alert, man.
Done right. With your composition. Yeah, these other things are just like a really lots of technical stuff. Like the graphics is real time in terms of real time. I don't know how to say it.
This is real. Basically, at the end of the day.
Basically, just think about it. It's like something like this. Something we will see in the 3D world is that we have to render this out. Where like rendering out means that we would have to, you know, let the system calculate all the light bounces and stuff. So with these cards now. This is live, meaning you can update, make the changes, and it would be as is. This is just as is. As you create it, it's just going to look like this.
Gotcha.
Which is a big deal. It is a big deal. Think about it as like your video games. Mm-hmm. So basically, this is what it is. It's like a live video game right now, if you think about it. All the calculations is being done on the graphics card real time. And I think that this is really cool. I like this.
This is the next. Look at the graphics.
Yes,
though.
and it's a step above.
It looks so clean, like dang.
Yeah, because it's path tracing. It's above ray tracing. Path tracing is just a little more calculations than a typical ray tracing. So yeah, so this is a big deal. Look how the light fall off is on those cubes. This is crazy.
This is right here. It's like, ladies and gentlemen, I know y'all gonna add this to y'all wish to y'all Christmas. When does it drop?
We're going to find out. Yeah, this is the part right now. So get ready.
Okay.
Takes over 20
main event.
Today we're announcing NVIDIA RTX IO with three new advances. New IO APIs for fast loading and streaming directly from SSD to GPU memory. GPU lossless decompression. And collaboration with Microsoft on direct storage for Windows that streamlines the transfer of data from storage to GPU memory. With NVIDIA RTX IO, vast worlds will load instantly. Picking up where you left off will be instant. This is a very big deal for next generation gaming. Let me show you Ampere in action in one of the most anticipated games of 2020, CD Projekt Red's Cyberpunk.
Cyberpunk?
This trailer is called Scenes of Cyberpunk RTX. It shows ray trace reflections, diffuse illumination, shadows, ambient occlusion, and DLSS 2.0. Enjoy.
Are you gonna pick that game up?
Cyberpunk, I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
It hasn't wowed me yet.
Yeah, I think I might just for the culture. It looks pretty good. It's kind of what I like.
Yeah. How much are you into role-playing games? Because I know you like fighting games a lot.
I mean, it's not that heavy, but it looks like a mix between Borderlands and Cyberpunk. It's like Borderlands in a way.
Like, for me, sometimes I wish I didn't have this competitive juice because it's like I want to go online and just like ruin people's lives.
Yeah.
Like, on multiplayer games. So, like, I wish I had, ladies and gentlemen, like, time to play role playing games.
Oh, the big just reveal. The big reveal.
GeForce mm-hmm. RTX 3080.
Powered
by Ampere.
Powered by Ampere.
Second generation RTX architecture.
Whoa. Did this freeze? Okay, we got to pause this. We got to go back.
Yeah, we got to run that.
We got to put a culture, bro.
Powered by Ampere.
It was too much power. Second just shut it down. Architecture. Okay, did it again.
Wow.
This one man
should have all that power, man. Kanye.
You got so much power, he's freezing the stream.
Right.
GPU, the NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3080, powered by Ampere, second generation RTX architecture.
Okay, we're good. Wow. Thanos. This is 256. Oh, this is cool.
Right.
Yo, this 690. Wait, are they building each graphics card with the fan? This is actually pretty cool. I like the fact how you see how they're building out the graphics card, the 1080. That was one of my best series, 1080.
1080?
Yeah, that was a really good. And now we have
The way they doing this on some Iron Man vibes.
Director Tony Stark.
Right. R.I.P. Structural sparse.
I don't even know what that is.
Right.
But it sounds great.
Yep. Right.
Those numbers. It sounds really great. Second gen.
Triangle into sections.
Oh. Whoa. Wait, is double facing? What? Double sided?
More airflow is a very good thing. That I know.
Okay, so the blue means it's coming in and it's going out of the top or bottom.
That's a very good question.
This is very pretty nice design. Okay.
Oh, 18 faces of power sounds interesting.
This is a really dope design for a graphics card.
It looks clean, man.
It's
clean.
Double-sided. Ooh.
The
NVIDIA RTX
38. Wow.
I have one right here.
Still like the real deal Holyfield, if you ask me.
Wait, he had it behind the thing on the whole time?
It is beautiful.
That's hilarious. Did he have it behind there the whole time?
We ain't even noticed.
Wait, hold up.
Mm-hmm.
Hold up. Let's rewind this thing.
Run that back.
Let's go to the beginning of this thing.
Right. It was there peeking out through the whole time, man. We got to see the camera.
He had it there the whole time. Look at that Easter egg.
He caught us because we're so focused on him.
We're so focused on him and all the colors there. We didn't notice. It's like right here.
That's probably an Easter egg right there.
That's an Easter egg, literally. Look at that. Gotti.
Got him.
Like, oh, this has been here the whole time.
That's hilarious.
It is beautiful. Look at this.
Wow, one of the best designs I've seen. The RTX 3080. This is really good.
It is wonderfully cool.
That leather jacket.
Look at that.
It's going to look beautiful in your PC.
Oh my God.
And it lights up.
I want four of them. I'm getting four.
Now let me tell you about some of the other exciting technologies inside.
This right here, man.
Turing used G6, the fastest memories at that time. The industry thought that was the limit. For Ampere, we had to push through that limit. Working with Micron, we designed
world's fastest graphics memory.
Pulse amplitude modulation. With four voltage levels that encode 2 bits of data each. 00011011. Each voltage step is only 250 millivolts. So in the same period of time, G6X can transmit twice as much data as G6. PAM4 is extreme signaling technology, and it's just becoming used in high-speed networking. The Ampere thermal architecture is the first ever flow-through design.
Yeah, they're showing up a real life. Okay, I got it.
This is kind of interesting, right? So if I wanted four of these, how would that work? Because before, right? For example, before how it used to work, it had like one blower card on the top and it would blow air out, you know, the back.
Mm-hmm.
So this was the intake and the exhaust was at the back. So if I have multiple cards now, it won't work as it did before.
Because you feel like it would like backfire on each other kind of?
Exactly, because if the exhaust is coming from the top here, which I'm guessing, yeah, it's going to take the intake. So you're
basically saying like too many would be like an overkill because it would like...
No, but I need too many.
it would like negate the other one's effect.
Yeah, I don't know if it's going to cause overheating. Maybe this is where you water cool. I'm thinking of probably something I will water cool. Have a nice water cool setup.
You put in two of these in your PC?
I have four of them right now.
Oh, four, okay.
But for this design, it won't work as the one I have previously. Because this design is, as you see, it's like dual-sided.
Yeah, it's pulling from both sides.
So like, say you can't put in another one at the bottom now because it's going to starve.
It'll like bounce, yeah, right.
It's going to starve it. So you won't get any clean air if you put one that's right under it. So it's not a big deal at all. From the outside.
Flowing through it's the probably a way around it. Possibly.
Yeah, water cool. You know, water cool. Room for a fan to flow air
directly through the module. Our engineers architect a super dense PCB design that is 50% smaller than previous.
So what they did, they actually made it. Yeah, they made the whole PCB board smaller to actually be able to accumulate. What was the word I'm looking for?
Accumulate.
Yeah. The new design.
While adding the bigger Ampere GPUs,
so much things goes into design, it's crazy.
PCI Express 4.0 and G6X. There are two independently controlled fans. The bracket front fan.
The importance of sizing the bottom
and pushes the heated air.
Okay, let's see. So the top fan takes. So this one goes exactly on top of the chip. So the top of the actual GPU chip is the front layer, and it blows out the case right away. See that one right here? So the blue at the top, right under it would be the chip. The chip will be here, the GPU chip. So that's going to cool it at the same time and push it out the case from the back.
Dope.
The backside pull through fan
and the bottom passes here.
Cool air over the fins of the heat pipe and directs the hot air to the top and back of the chassis.
I love how they do this.
So you see like this part here is where the GPU is going to connect to the heatsink. Right? Mm-hmm. And so this is the bottom of the case. So it's going to take the air from the bottom of the case and output it to the top. And that's where your exhaust fan from your CPU case is going to pull it to push it out. Because hot air rises, right? System. Science?
The 3080 flow through system is 3 times quieter and keeps the GPU 20 degrees cooler than the Turing design. It can cool 90 watts more than Turing.
That's a big deal. Being quiet is a big deal.
Especially for streaming.
It's so loud sometimes. Yeah, for sure.
Because even my setup here, I think it's pretty quiet, but I still hear it.
Right, and it's like, how do I hear you? It kind of irks you a little bit, you know?
Yeah, it does. Inspire content developers to create the next level
of content, and for the install base to upgrade. Yes, content creation.
Have you ever had any of these cards? What card do you have right now? This is crazy.
G-Force.
This is crazy.
I got the G-Force.
This is freaking crazy. What made this so crazy right now is the fact that, I mean, I have the 980 Ti, I have the 1080 Ti, I have the 2080 Ti. So I have basically like three of those Ti. The Ti is basically the highest end of the consumer brackets.
Right.
I paid, for example, right? Okay, so like back in 2017 when the 1080 Ti came out, I paid about $700 for that.
You said 2018?
2017.
Okay.
I paid like $700 for that. The 2080 Ti, I paid about the same price they have over here, $1,200.
$1,200, wow.
Yeah. And the 3080 Ti... Which looks from this thing, which looks from this chart, is like twice the power of the 2080 Ti, is the same price of the 1080 Ti.
And it lets you know, like, it's the real deal, Holyfield.
This is kind of crazy. So I don't know. So actually, Nick, I feel like, why did I get the 2080 Ti? Because now you have something that's twice the power of the 2080 Ti, but for half the price. I think a lot of 2080 Ti owners going to be mad, especially if you bought it this year. You're going to be mad.
Like, damn, I waste my money. But it's because the times was different now.
Yeah,
you know?
Times, technology, man. But exactly. This, we never had a jump. If you look at the chart right here, there never been such a jump in power
almost ever.
No, only once it had. If you look at the thing, it's from the 980 Ti. From the 980 to the 1080 Ti, that's when you had that one generation double jump. So the last time that happened was from the 980 to the 1080 Ti. From the 1080 Ti to the 2080 Ti, there was not that. It wasn't a jump, a twice power jump. But this one here has twice the performance.
Than the top dog
now for half the price.
That right there, like,
this is gonna have the internet go nuts right now. All the gamers are just punching. You bought a 2080 Ti, you punching air right now. Like,
that's a fact. Be mad.
You guys need to get on eBay right now.
I can't wait for the release date.
Let's see the price. What was the price?
I think it was like $699. Something around there, right? That ballpark.
Think about it. 2 months ago, you bought your 2080 Ti for $1,200. Now something that's twice the power is out here for half the price. You're punching air right now.
Some people definitely going to use the. They're gonna use the 30-day return policy.
Yeah. All of a sudden, you call them like, "Hey, like, NVIDIA, my graphics card broke. It just broke. I don't know. It can't work. I don't want any. I just want a new one. Okay.
That's
can I return common. It? I just want a new one right now. 3080, our new
flagship GPU. Powered by this is powerful, man. Generation
RTX GPU twice the performance of the 2080. Incredible amounts of processing in the shader, RT ray tracing. You love teraflops. And Tensor Core for
processing AI. What's a teraflop?
Twice the processing. Is it 1,000? I think it's more than 1,000.
Starting at
$699 available September 17th.
I'm
going to pre-order 4.
970. Ooh. 1070. 2070, we're all hugely. I'm a pre-order one. You're gonna love the
new RTX 3070. Look at that, like, faster than they are so. How are you gonna jump? Oh, hold up. Did you just see what happened there?
No.
Okay, so NVIDIA usually drops. Okay, so NVIDIA is usually like this. They have like these sub numbers, right? Mm-hmm. So they usually goes from the 50s, right? So this is from the last generation, is the 20 series, right? So the 20 series have the 2060, the 2070, the 2080, right? So that could explain the scale. So for this generation, right, the 3070 is equal to last generation's 2080 Ti, right? But the price
is not the same.
The price is at the 2070 price.
Wow, they gonna be mad.
People are punching air right now.
They gonna be tight. It just
people are
just
punching.
Not, but it just registered with me. Like they gonna be mad. It's like, wow.
People are gonna be mad because
I'm mad for them.
You've just bought a 2080 Ti.
Saved up for a while
for $1,200. Wait, let's see the price of this one.
It gotta be like $499. Let me see. Tensor Core for AI processing. Gotta be $499.
8 GB of G6. 8 GB of RAM. So it just has 3 GB of RAM less, which is not really a big deal for most people. $499. Boom.
Yeah, called it.
Look at, listen.
Called it.
NVIDIA themselves, look what NVIDIA is saying right here. The GeForce RTX 3070 faster than the 2080 Ti for $1,200. Starting at $499.
Big man, that's like half. That's like literally like half.
It's less than half.
Like it's less than much. Half. Like, that's great. That is.
You bought a 2080 Ti 2 months ago.
It's true what they say. Patience is a virtue, but man, this is
you were not. I was not expecting this kind of increase. Nobody was expecting this. NVIDIA is in competition with themselves because their competitors are. What's it called? I even forgot the company name. It doesn't even matter no more. They don't.
It really doesn't.
The competition is AMD, and AMD cannot compete with this. This is bananas.
This is next level for sure.
They just beat out their own high-end product. Their flagship product was the 2080 Ti. they're in so much competition in themselves that they beat out, they actually beat out their own product for half the price. It's like, what? Okay.
Yo, this is gonna sell right here. This is it. This is for the gamers. This is for the content creation. This is for everything.
This is like, nuts.
This right here.
This is for us. Nuts.
This is for us.
This
man.
Is nuts.
I'm so excited.
I don't know what Nvidia just AMD'd. AMD.
Right.
AMD is basically it's a chipset manufacturer. So AMD, this thing what Nvidia is doing right now is what AMD is doing to Intel for CPUs, for like, you know, your graphic, your central processing units on your computer. No, not the graphics card, but like, you know, the clock speed of your computer. So right now, AMD and Intel is having like this whole the CPU war. So what Nvidia is doing now is what AMD is doing to Intel. But AMD cannot compete with Nvidia in graphics card. You get what I'm saying? So CPU-wise, they're beating Intel. But for graphics card-wise, Nvidia just Nvidia is so bad, they just killing themselves. They're undercutting themselves. They're like, what?
They're gonna have a lot of new customers, I'll tell you that.
I could imagine being in that boardroom. Boardroom, right? Imagine that. It's like, okay, so we're gonna release the new cars. Yes, that's cool.
Right.
Yeah, and it's gonna be faster than our best model, and it's gonna be less than half the price.
Right.
Yeah, wait, what?
People just looking around like,
wait, what? Wait.
What's going on here? Half the price.
Wait. So the $500 card is better than our $1,200 card? That's what you're saying? Yes.
That should turn into a price drop for those for the previous ones.
Yeah, I'm like, wait, what?
Like, it would have to. Those are about to be obsolete right now.
It's already obsolete. They don't even exist anymore. I'm like, wait, why would I go to Microsoft and buy a $1,200 card while it's coming for $500
to purchase that? Right. We pack in our best ideas. Literally. While introducing new features that
enhance image quality. This is bananas. This is crazy. As it did with
Pascal, and we get a giant generation. Pascal, this is I'm hyped. Perfect 10.
Pascal was great. Pascal was the 1080 Ti. The reason, a little quick backstory about this is that AMD was supposed to release this big graphics card. So Nvidia, they wanted to jump out ahead of them, and they created the 1080 Ti, which was like the GPU for the miners and everybody. So back in 2017, those things were selling like hotcakes. They were the Nintendo Switch of 2017.
Wow.
The 1080 Ti's. It was such a big gap that when the 2080s drop, when they released the 2080 series back in 2018 or whatnot, it looked like such a small increase because it did so well with a 1080 Ti. So basically, if you had a 1080 Ti, you never saw a reason to go to the 2080 Ti's.
Sound like a hot commodity.
Yeah, so basically, right now, he's saying like, hey guys, all you guys who had the Pascal, so they usually name it like, so the 1080 series had the Pascal, that's the code name, basically the Pascal chip.
Right.
The 2080 Ti's and stuff, they had the Torin, and this new one is Ampher, or something like that, so he's basically saying, now you guys could upgrade. It took the super family of Turing to meaningfully exceed Pascal. Screw you guys that bought the Torrent chips. You guys in the background.
Yo, man, I feel it. Man, anybody, let us know in the comments.
Yo, let me know if you guys feel the same way. How many of you guys, I only bought one. I'll be honest, I bought one 2080 Ti, but I bought it last year, so I'm not punching air as you guys. Most people are. Right. If you bought it this year or a month ago, I know you guys are. I'll be big mad right now.
Be big mad, yo. Without ray tracing. With ray tracing turned on, Pascal, using programmable shaders to compute ray triangle intersections, fell far behind his RT core. And Turing with ray tracing on reached the Pascal with ray tracing. And I love how you could just see literally visually the scale.
Yeah.
The
images are far more beautiful, and reflection and shadow artifacts are gone. But gamers want it more. They want every generation to be more realistic and higher frame rate at the same time.
So we double down on this. This is big. Oh my God.
I know, like, what is going to get people big mad about this is honestly the people that bought in that previous generation. You basically bought a beta product. You paid for the R&D for this to happen. So don't be too mad.
In that perspective, man, that kind of stinks.
Yeah, because
like, beta because that price.
No, I agree, because even when it first dropped, the 2080 Ti's, and I saw the price was like $1,200 and $1,500 and such, I was like, wait, this is way too high for graphics card. And but that's when they introduced the new, you know, the RTX and the ray tracing, the real-time ray tracing. So now when you think about it now, it's like what you did for that higher price and such for the graphics card, you basically was funding the R&D for this to happen. So basically now they just brought it back down to the real price.
The good price.
This is happy price right now. What?
$499?
This is a no-brainer. Like, who's gonna be? Oh, no, I'm not gonna buy it. What?
Yeah, this is it.
$499 for like double the performance.
Like,
yeah, because now you're paying 1/3 of what you would have paid a month ago. Brand new. This is sell off. Like triple double.
Ampere knocks the daylight out of Pascal on ray tracing. It's like saying, hey, we give y'all LeBron James. And then after that, it's like somebody that's like 10 times better than LeBron James. So it's like, huh? At cheaper cost? Shit is crazy. Call of Duty, baby. Just in time. Look at this. Shadows and ambient occlusion, DLSS 2.0, and NVIDIA Reflex super low latency technology. The last Call of Duty sold in May. So this dropped September 13th, I believe it was?
17th.
Oh, 17th.
I think it's going to be an announcement to pre-order. I'm going to pre-order like four of them. I'm getting into the 3080. I'm getting four of them.
Four 3080s?
Yeah. I'm going to build a whole new system just for this.
Can't wait to see that on your YouTube page, man. That's going to be exciting.
It's going to be great. I'm going to do a really good
one. Subscribe to Leon. Amazing guy.
This is real time right now for the Call of Duty. Like, for games, it's going to be epic. Look at this. This is a great time to be a gamer.
It really is, man. It's good for the content creation, for gaming, everything, man. It just, everything is working faster or cheaper. You cannot go wrong with that. It's an investment. Has to be done.
Look at this. Oh, my.
Man, I cannot wait for this game to come out. Finally, gonna be November 13th.
Let me talk to you about one more thing. Several years ago, we started building the Titan,
pushing the GPU to the absolute limit. Oh yeah, I know the Titan. Those things cost like $2,500. It was built in limited quantities only through NVIDIA. The distribution was
creatives were making 4K movies, rendering cinematics. Researchers built workstations for data and AI. Bloggers built broadcast workstations. Oh, look at that setup.
Oh, I want one.
Oh, the chair?
Yeah, the pod.
The pod? Oh, yeah, the pod. Right. Correction. Autocorrect. Ladies and gentlemen, the RTX
3090. What is this guy doing in his kitchen? This guy's kitchen got like all these secret compartments.
My man.
Oh, yeah, he's cooking it up. Wow, that's a big cart. That's a monster. A BF, big effing GPU. That's what it's called. You see it? BF GPU?
Right.
Big effing GPU.
Big ass GPU.
1500. Ooh. That's a little too much, a little bit, yeah. I can't get four of those. Should I get a new car? Should I build a new system? Comment below.
Oh, man.
But this is beast, though. It's beast, though. See, I was debating. It's too big. It's too big. It's three slots. It just takes up like three slots of it. It's too big.
Wow. I wonder what he has in the fridge. What do you think he got in the fridge?
What you got in the fridge?
I wonder.
Some salads.
Right. He's filling out soul from behind on a countertop. Never been more excited to do anything. Probably got something in the microwave chilling, right? Oh my god. Morgenstern. The resolution on this is clean, man. Like you said before, man, it's a good time for gaming, man.
It's a really good time to be a great much content creator. I am so, dude, I was expecting, like, the way the rumors were going, I thought this was going to cost more.
I thought it would be at least two.
I mean, it's crazy because, you know, it is pricey. It's not even pricey. I will take that back. I would say it's not pricey because you're literally getting
better performance.
You're getting double the performance of last gen for half the price because, like, if you think about it, if people were buying a $1,200 GPU,
right.
You know, even though they're still punching the air right now, they should be happy. They should be happy.
That like you sell that on eBay, get that like $300, $400, put that towards the note.
Bro, that's a heavy discount now, bro. It's like,
man. So imagine getting this already discounted price at a discounted price, man. Christmas,
bro. I mean, yeah. Like you, for example, for my work. You know, I get four of them. That's what, 28 for like. That's how much. Even just times the power there, I'm probably gonna get like what, 8 times what I'm doing now.
That's intense.
For 28, yeah. Which is not bad if you think about it. I'll do like, you know, I'll do 3D motion graphics. You know what I'm saying? Right. For like 4K, I'm getting the ultimate system.
Like just like that alone sells the product.
Yeah, because
I don't know what it does.
Yeah, like, if you just look at the numbers, it's saying twice the performance. Like everything is twice the performance.
At the cheaper price.
It's like what? Like I was expecting this to be like, I mean, the 3090 is $1,500. I'm not getting that, but like $700. Yeah, I'm gonna get. I could get those. I could get the $700. $500. That's gonna be equal to the $1,500 GPU.
Right. That's like me, who's new into gaming, who's very new rookie. This is pleasing to me to hear. It's like,
yeah.
What?
Didn't you buy a PC? Your PC came with the 1660 Ti.
Yeah, mine. Right? Mine is.
So basically, for $500, you could get. That's going to be at least 6 or 8 times the power of your 1660.
What I have now, exactly.
For $500.
Can't wait to put that bad boy in this, for sure. I'm going to feel too powerful, man. Game is gonna be fun.
You just need an 8K screen now.
Right. It's crazy. I'm still waiting for my monitor, man. Come on, USPS. Come on. Meanwhile, NVIDIA GPU processing. Gamers grew to billions, yes sir. Man, I wanna see him pull something out that leather jacket, man.
He's gonna pull it. He's like, wait, and one more thing. And there's more. Today's Ampere
launch is a giant. Might have copped that 380.
Yeah, I'm glad the 380.
Let us know in the comments. Which one y'all, whoever's interested in buying this product, let us know what y'all gonna get or what you're interested in getting. We want to know.
Yeah, I want to know. You know, definitely, I would recommend for like, you know, as a 3D artist. And I think the 3080 is the best value because the 3090 is essentially kind of a
OP.
I mean, you get more VRAM, but it's actually double the price. You know what I'm saying? For what I do, I need more like raw processing power than actual RAM. So I will go with the 3080. But yeah, this is really good though. This is really, I'm like, I never been so excited to see some graphics cards in my life.
Yeah, this is a big deal today, ladies and gentlemen. This is, look into it, do your research, because I'm doing my research as well. Fairly new. This is, man, I'm excited. Like, quarter four is going to be so, man, new consoles, new games. It feels refreshing.
All right, and that's it. It's about to be out. All right. Thank you, NVIDIA, for this. This is amazing, amazing, amazing technology. I mean, the year itself has been bad, but the end of the year is getting better.
Yes, man. What was that album? What a Time to Be Alive?
Yeah, we're getting what, the PS5. Now we're getting the NVIDIAs. We're getting the Xboxes.
Right.
You know,
gaming is gonna be crazy, man. At the end of the year.
Oh yeah, great gaming streaming is an all time high. You know, I created my gaming channel. Like, you know, I'll plug it in.
Right, know, plug it in, man. Let them know.
Yeah, plug it in. You know, you could follow me there. I game sometimes. So yeah, I mean, we have a lot going on, man. So this has been really good. I really liked what NVIDIA did. NVIDIA, I mean, they start cannibalizing themselves. It's like,
right?
I never see somebody that undercut their own product. It's like end of life their own product.
It's something behind that, because I guess they know they want to reach out to the masses. You know, it's like,
yeah. That's what I think. I think they're leaving like little to no room for the competition.
Exactly.
Because like. For $500, you get their flagship product. So how could you even compete? Like, for example, for AMD, one of their flagship product, which I used before, was the 5700 XT, and that was it was all right, you know. For reference, the $500 AMD card is equal to the $300 NVIDIA card. But the so basically AMD highest consumer kind of grade card, what they have in the IMAX and stuff, is equal to a $300 NVIDIA card. So that's how the competition is, where NVIDIA is leading so much in this. It's not even a fair race. It's like Usain Bolt versus
this is crazy, man.
It's versus a toddler right now. It's bananas. I mean, I know AMD got something big, but I think that's why NVIDIA kind of prices so aggressively, whereas like they're giving them no room. So like AMD, to even beat them, they have to come up with something probably more expensive.
I mean, ideally, because what are they gonna do?
They can't compete with those prices. Like, I don't know how you're gonna compete with $500 for something that powerful.
This is very amazing too, because it's like you're being a team owner, and it's like, all right, you sit there and you're just like, okay, you're analyzing, and you're like, who's gonna be my franchise player? 380, 373. It's like you have the choice.
Right now AMD is in so much trouble. Like, as you know, I follow a lot of graphics cards. So basically, they hit them on the
they're punching the air right now as we speak.
About it, right? The 2080 AMD didn't have any competition for the 2080 Ti, right? And what they basically did, their lowest offering for $499 is faster than the 2080 Ti. You see how they changed up the whole playing field? So it's like, for $499, you can get a 2080 Ti, which AMD has no competition for. For $699, you can get... $689, you could get something that's twice as powerful.
NVIDIA really just put AMD in a Silo Oricalco, so I'll tell you that.
If I'm AMD right now, I'm like, wait, what?
What they gonna do for this? Like,
I don't know. We're gonna see. I mean, they have something. They should. I don't even know. I honestly don't know, because
your back's against the wall for sure.
Yeah, it's definitely against the wall. You know, I would love to see. Competition is great. Like, I mean, competition from AMD is making NVIDIA do these. I'm like, oh my, it's great. It's a great time to be a consumer.
Magnificent time to be a consumer.
Competition is great for consumers. Yeah. We're winning on this. So I'm like, we're not losing.
It's so, the first I had in a while, to be honest with you.
I mean, the only losers here are the 2080 Ti owners.
they punching the air right now. Low Mac.
Man. I don't know, NVIDIA about to get a bunch of RMA requests. Like, my graphics card just broke. I don't know, today, at this moment, it just broke.
Customer support, press 1 if you want to. For 2, if you're an angry customer who bought it previously. 3, press 3 if...
if we're already blowing up right now, it's like, my graphics card don't work no more. It just doesn't work. I need you guys to take it back now.
Do you have... sir, ma'am, do you have water damage? can you send us pictures of your device?
Nah, it's gonna be crazy. You guys just undercut yourself. How do you end? I don't know. I'll be big mad right now. But so this has been great. Hope you guys enjoy this thing. Anything you gotta say?
I'm gonna be streaming soon. Catch me on Twitch for right now. Asukiyomi.
Yeah. Links is gonna be below. Our podcast link is gonna be below. We just launched that, if you're into that.
Follow us on social media. Hit us in the DMs. Let us know.
All right. So thank you guys for watching, and we're out of here.
Peace out.
Yeah, so we're back again, guys. Just wanted to back show you guys.
White bands.
Yeah, we just... Back again, guys. We just wanted to show you guys the difference between the power. What's going on here? So you have...
Show me the Venn diagram, man.
Exactly.
Go.
Let's show you the Venn diagram, please.
Mm-hmm.
So you have the 3090 for $1,500. You're getting 10,000 CUDA cores. You have the 3080 for $699, $700. You get it almost 9,000 CUDA cores. With the 3070, you're getting 6,000 CUDA cores for $499, $500. Let's go. Let's see the pricing right now of the current 2080 the current gen. So let's go. We are Micro Center. Let's see what we get in here. Micro Center. All right. So they have refurbished. So they have for $1,200. The specs on that right now, we're getting.
Keep in mind, ladies and gentlemen, refurbished.
Yeah, for refurbished stuff, we're getting what here? 4,000. So it's less than for less than $500, we're getting like double the power. Let's go to Amazon. Let's see what Amazon got. I think Amazon price is even higher.
You know Amazon move fast, so they done drop everything.
Oh, yeah, right, they need to just delete this thing out of the world.
Jeff Bezos is like, wait, what?
They need to delete this out of the world. Okay, so on even Amazon renewed. We're looking at $1,500. Why? They need to get 15 less. People are still buying this right now. They're going to be punching air right now.
You imagine somebody that's buying that today, like making that purchase.
They're going to be punching air right now because basically, yeah. Amazon renewed is $1,500, where you can wait a month. Wait, it's coming out this month, 2 weeks, and you can buy it
like 15 days.
Yeah, so you're getting double the power for $500 and $700. Yeah. Okay, Amazon. Okay, that is crazy. This is why this is such a big deal.
This is definitely like.
This is a huge deal.
I can't even speak.
and they also cut down the Titan. For example, the 3090 is basically a redone Titan. Right, so the Titan goes for $2,500, right? And you're getting, what do you get with the Titan? Let's see the CUDA cores here. You're getting 4,600 CUDA cores for $2,500. In the RTX series, we're getting 6,000 for $500.
Yo, this is like,
so unless you need the GPU, the 24 gigabyte GPU, for $500, you're getting something that is technically faster than the Titan for $2,500.
Doesn't this feel like a paradise? It's just like, wow.
What is going on here? Just look at these numbers, and it just makes you think. It's like, wait, what happened in the NVIDIA boardroom right now?
Yeah. what the heck is going on today?
What happened in that boardroom? Because this is just crazy.
You got the feeling like, is this a prank?
It's a prank. You're like, gotcha.
Yeah, right?
It's like, oh yeah, our graphic designer did a mistake. So, yeah.
Right.
These prices should be, actually, let's add a couple of zeros to it. So, yeah.
Man, This is a W. Put the W up.
Oh yeah, this is a big W. Yeah.
Content creators, everybody that owns PCs, new gamers, new PC owners like myself, like this is a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, mind you, if you take away the RAM segment of it, just in raw power, these cards all beat the Titan. So unless you absolutely need the extra RAM for your high super high quality scenes, because I never got into the point where I needed to like need that extra gigabyte of RAM. I was fine with a 1080 Ti. All
right. I mean, can we call Titan a Titan anymore? Like,
it's not even a Titan. It's like you're stripped of your name.
Literally,
you're stripped of your name. You're less than you're a 3060. The Titan is basically a 3060 now. It's like it's a 3060 for $2,500 more. You got stripped of your name.
Oh my god, that's so funny. That's so funny right there. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Dethroned, man.
Yeah. I can't believe you dethroned your own product. This is bananas. Like,
wow.
Yeah, I just had to bring this back because this is just crazy. Shout out to NVIDIA, man. I don't know. They give everybody a good, great.
That's, you know what? Now I think about it, this is what happened in the boardroom. It was like, you know what, man? We're going to do this for the culture. And he did it for the culture.
We're going to save the world right now.
All praise to y'all. I hope y'all stock prices go higher after this. Like, this is a big deal.
This is crazy. These types of prices is a steal. I'm ordering 4 of these. Might have to resell it. This is going to be such a steal. I'm going to be for mine.
This is like getting a Ventador for like $80,000.
Yeah, it's a crazy steal. This is, I can't even tell you. These are the prices right now, and this is the quality. I didn't even know they really outdone themselves. I've never seen something. Not only is a dramatic boost in performance. For lower the price, where does this happen?
It, to be honest, it doesn't happen. This is cultural purposes.
Yeah.
Man, I'm excited for this.
Yeah. All right.
Especially being fresh with this, I'm excited. Yeah, man.
All right. This is dope. All right. See you guys next time.
Deuces.